Good morning from a sunny Rome, or actually Vatican City again. We went back today because we weren't able to get into the Basilisk yesterday. I'm a bit out of breath because we've been rushing to get here. But we made it again. We're at the Vatican. And the line is very, very short, so we're gonna head in there and go inside the Basilisk. Basilica. Sounds like basil for some reason. Anyway, we'll take you guys with us.
Whisper a little bit, guys, but what you're seeing right here is 136 meters above the ground. The side there, so these areas here, are about 46 meters up in the air. This is absolutely insane, the height. Like, the GoPro doesn't capture it well, so I'm trying to narrate a little bit, but I'm in a church, I can't really speak too loud. These things are massive.
If it's silent in dismay, it won't break this feeling down. If I conquer this my way, I'd devour, I'd surround. If it hurts you just a little, then it heals you when it's done. Disappointment is the anchor, resolution is the sun. sit silent in dismay. It won't break this feeling down. If I conquer this my way, I'd devour, I'd surround. If it hurts you just a little, then it heals you when it's done. Disappointment is the anchor, resolution is the sun.
So we just walked from the fountain to a temple for Hadrian, which was closed. And now we made it to the place where Brutus killed Julius Caesar. It's an excavation site, obviously. But Brutus stabbed Julius Caesar about 23 times here and killed him, which is this location right here. So we are back at the hotel now. It is 1:30, which means that we have spent a decent chunk of time in the city, but we're not done yet. So we're gonna go to the room, get changed a little bit, change the shoes, and we're gonna get into the car, drive to a national park, which I don't know the name of anymore. And just walk around there, see some stuff. I'm gonna go to Castella dell'Orsini, I think it's called. Which is funny because my old teacher was called Orsini. So we're gonna check it out and we'll take you guys with us. As you can see on the road, there is a carabinieri, which is military police, standing in the middle of it. But it was very unclear at this point if he was trying to stop me or if I was allowed to drive through. So the thing is, the way he was holding his stick or sign meant or would mean in the Netherlands that you have to drive through, that you have to continue your way. And as we drive past him, you can actually see that he is at this point like really angry. waving his sign around that we had to stop. So just as a precaution, I actually pulled over to the side a little bit further away where we waited for him to actually come up to us, at which point he did. And well, you can actually hear on the background, and I put some subtitles in as well. You can actually see what's happening.
Hello. Turn around.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, I come back, yeah.
Scherpe bocht naar links naar Via Anguilla Reze SB5A.
Okay, no.
Where do you come?
Holland.
The Netherlands. We're on a holiday. Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Okay.
Yeah, as is a kind of tradition at this point, we stopped off at our local restaurant again. We had some, well, I should say they're called supli, which are risotto filled, well, deep fried balls basically that we had, and some codfish. And the pizza, of course, that was again really, really good. This is a different version of the one that I had on the first night. And my dad had a like tuna fish or tuna. And onion version, I think it was, which was pretty good. So that's it for today again. We're gonna go out tomorrow. We're gonna actually sleep in tomorrow morning, and we're gonna go hit the road. We're gonna drive somewhere. I'm trying to figure out where we have to go. I'm actually checking it on the laptop right now, where we're gonna go tomorrow, and just gonna drive inland. I'll take you guys again with us on this, well, amazing journey so far. I'm really happy that we were able to do this. And I'm really, there's so much learning, that I've, so much stuff that I've learned, so much stuff that I have tried out, like food-wise, that normally we don't really eat in Netherlands. So I'm really happy for that as well. And for now, I wish you all a good night or a good morning, whatever you guys are coming from. And I'll catch you guys in the next one.